Well, I don't know if it's a good way to start the show or a bad way to start the show, but we are going to start the show with a Cleveland Brown. How do you feel about that?
Did you say shart the show?
He said he sharted.
With the Cleveland Browns.
I sharted.
I'm really ready for them to be better. I don't know if it's ever going to happen, but they do have some players on their team that have some fantasy relevance, so let's see if we're in, right? We got some Corey Coleman's.
We got some Corey Coleman. And
73 on the current ADP.
There's some talks of a possible prior return. There's been rumblings of a Coleman trade, which would be okay with me. If you obviously wanted to get rid of Coleman, that's fine. As Jay Wayne mentioned, he's at ADP of 73 for February here. What do you guys make on? I'm personally not really down on him too much. He's obviously been a little banged up through the first couple of years. When he's had his chances, it's been pretty decent. Obviously, Josh Gordon came back at the end of last year, like we talked about last week. They kind of force-fed him some balls. It would kind of hurt old Corey Coleman last year at the end of the season when he did come back.
Yeah, so three straight games with one catch to end the year, 15, 16, 17.
Right, and you know, not the best quarterback play and not the best situation, so... You know,
but
how do you
still
guys
a
feel?
Solid ADP here,
right?
So it's crazy because he really hasn't done.
It's not solid if you bought him last
right,
year.
Right, it's slowly been deteriorating.
I think it made its way up to 24 at one point. I was looking at the history on the DLFs, and it made it to 24 at some point. I don't know exactly
it's hanging
when
on.
It was, but
it's hanging on,
still hanging on. But he hasn't really done much. I mean, his 56 catches over the past 2 years. He's missed 13 games in the last two seasons. Broke his hand, required surgery in 16. Broke the same hand, I believe, in 17 that required surgery. Sports injury predictor said that it was the same hand, but I've gotten burned by them before on this podcast because they had the wrong data. So I don't know, but he did break his hand twice, two different years. But he missed the first seven games of last season and then comes out versus Jacksonville, one of the best pass defenses in the league.
Well, he played week one and two.
Well, sure, but then he missed seven games, right? Comes back, first game versus Jacksonville, puts up 6 for 80. Now, this was before Josh Gordon, but like that's a solid score to come back after breaking your hand against one of the best pass defenses in the league playing for the Browns.
Yeah, I had picked him up and stashed him a few weeks before that in a redraft league and was scared to death to play him in the Jacksonville game and then fired him up the next game and, you know, wasn't a terrible day, but it wasn't what I was expecting after a nice day against the Jaguars. And then, Jesus, the game after that.
Yeah.
Goose egg.
He's only had one game over 100 yards his whole career, which is kind of like there's a lot of reasons to be down on this guy, but for some reason, I'm still interested. I'm still down to put him on my team.
The physical traits are great, and that's what's keeping him at the 74. Obviously, you know he's a vertical threat. He's a burner. If you can put a decent quarterback and another good receiver on the other side of him, you would have to think that Corey Coleman can eat and do his thing.
Yeah, he hasn't Kevin Whited or Breshad Perriman, you know. He's still hanging on. But and coming out, he was my favorite wide receiver. I'm not, you know.
In that particular draft class.
In that draft class. He was. I really, really liked him a ton. Not going to pretend like I didn't. And it's just one of those things. Like, you get hurt. Is he got the Keenan Allen syndrome? Is he going to come back? Not that he's a PPR monster like Keenan Allen, but he's a big play guy. The 6 for 80, the 5 for 53 for a touch just this year with DeShone Kizer throwing him the ball, the rookie. And then the year before, you know, before he gets hurt or in between, he comes back, scores some decent points and gets
hurt
again.
Had like one good game his rookie year that sustained his value throughout the offseason.
But he flashed like that two touchdown big play. But what you thought he could do coming out, he showed it to you. But it's just such a small sample size at this point because he's hardly on the field. It's just one of those things where how much more of this can you take?
Sure. I will say this. I mean, it's at 73, but like you just mentioned, he was your favorite receiver in that draft class. I mean, Sterling Shepard has come out and had two nice years by all accounts and is 12 picks ahead of him, 13 picks ahead of him.
Good point.
So this ADP is staying pretty strong. I'm not saying that that's really worth too much, but I mean, his value is staying, you know, right up there with Sterling Shepard, who's actually been on the field and proving himself and, you know, seems to, you know what I'm saying here?
Yeah, especially this time. This is February ADP because it's March 3rd. March isn't out yet. And you just mentioned a guy a couple of picks ahead of him that was in the same draft class. And in front of that draft class was Devontae Parker, who has done nothing but let his people down year after year after year. But he's at 74 right behind Corey Coleman. It's potential season. Mm-hmm. In February, your ADP, it's all potential. And that's what happens. And Corey Coleman is filled with potential. Still is. We haven't seen him go out there and not be good. He's good when he's out there. He's just not out there much. So the potential were capital P. He's still got a ton of potential. But obviously he's a Cleveland Brown, so when he's been out there, it's been hard to get a decent target thrown his way. And the biggest thing we just mentioned briefly and then got past it because we were trying to get going on him and get revved up here. Josh Gordon comes back just demanding targets. And then if Pryor goes over there, we kind of mentioned it last week when we talked about Pryor, the three of them on one team in Cleveland, that's disaster.
It can't be great. Maybe they do get one of these free agent quarterbacks who can help them out, because Hugh was saying how he didn't want to start a rookie. And then you bring Todd Haley in, who is a pretty decent and well-respected offensive mind. And I'm kind of interested to see what he can do with this team. If they can get a quarterback, they could have a good offense. But I could see what you're saying. It could be, you know, a little muddy over there with those three guys, and it's the Browns. And to hope that all that turns around that quickly is probably a little bit of a...
He's 20, he's 23. Calvin Ridley's about to be drafted. He's 23.
Sure.
You know what I mean? So if Pryor goes over there and
about to turn 24.
Okay. Well, yeah, exactly. I'm not looking at birthday here, but
23.7 is where he's at.
Close enough. Well, so... You get what I'm saying. He's super sure. Young, super potential. It's just...
So you guys in or out at 73? We'll start with Jay Wayne over there.
I think... I don't know that you're going to see the dividends right away, but it's Dynasty. I'm in. I'm still in. I think I'd take him over Devontae Parker as well at 74 there. I don't know. That's a whole other discussion. I don't know if you want to answer that question
I think I know at least I'm probably going to say this on a couple of guys here, and I'm going to spend it on my first guy here. But Corey Coleman's the type of guy who isn't going to take but two or three games having some decent games, because there's a ton of people who liked Corey Coleman, and obviously his value staying strong before the value's right back up to the 50s, 40s, 30s. Just in a couple of games, I think the value will shoot back up. See, I knew Corey Coleman was good.
Right.
And so, you know, maybe you get in there at 73 and maybe you could do a quick flip around in the beginning of the season or hold him. So I'm intrigued, like you said, by the potential. And I think I'm okay with 73. This is a decent discount for him. I think I like him more than Devontae Parker at this point. For me personally, I'm going to take Sterling Shepard and probably pass on both of these guys. But
best thing that could happen to him is that Pryor comes over. They feel a little bit crowded over there. They trade Corey Coleman to anybody else. Best thing that could happen to him. And to that measure, if we're going to say, hey, you're on the clock and you got to make a pick here, I may slide on down. And if I'm going to put my stock in a young wide receiver, I might just slide on down and grab Chris Godwin.
All right. Well, I mean, so you're basically saying that you're out at 73?
If whoever bought Corey Coleman to begin with is upset, whoever bought into him last year being like, oh, well, it is what it is, and we'll get him this year because he was hurt, and then two straight hand injuries, that could scare you. I would be buying Corey Coleman from a current owner. But in a startup, everything's different. You're blank slate. You're coming in here creating your team. I don't mind buying in at Corey Coleman's drop in value to a current owner with a team. I can package up a couple of guys I don't really like and try to pick him up. But in my startup draft, I'm probably not taking Corey Coleman at 73.
I look at it as maybe I want to take Sterling Shepard a little further up the line here and probably take somebody else here just because I feel a little more comfortable. But at the point where you're taking him at 73 or whatever that is, I feel like it's a decent swing to take at that point. You've got a couple of guys, and depending on how you built your roster, you're probably you got some safe guys and maybe a home run or two in there, and then this is another guy who could potentially be a little bit more of a fun kind of swing.
Couple games he shoots right back up the board. So 5-12 is pick 60, so that means 72 is the end of the sixth round. So 73 is the beginning of 7-1. Basically, 6-12 is 72. So 7-1, the first pick in the seventh round. I mean, that's the cheapest you got in Corey Coleman in 2 years in Dynasty.
And it
absolutely
could be a quick flip, mentioned. So
a couple games he jumps
I think I'm okay with still buying in there.
Yeah.
All right.
Absolutely.